Yep, because you don't want to kill her, obviously, for the Commonwealth Games. If she's selected for the Commonwealth Games, you want her to be in peak condition for that, and that's going to be a great learning curve for the World Juniors later in the year.
Now, we were mentioning that 2:13 would be the target. Yes. I think the way that she came off the start probably pointing towards not going for that 2:13.
True, but like we said before, she knows the splits that she's capable of. She would be on the training track and there'd be sessions that heptathletes would absolutely hate doing. I'm sure there'd be rep 200s with short recovery. And she would know what ability she has at in the last 400 of an eight. So she, even though she has great raw speed, she still can't go out there and say hit the first lap in 60 flat. It has to be close to that 65 to 68 seconds if she's going to have any opportunity to do that time.
But exactly. And there's a lot of other little races going on here. So Alicia Burnett, she's well out in front there in she's in second place at the moment, but well in front of third and fourth. But there's only a few short points between, and I think only 9 points between Tori Rest and Kiara Dingus. So there is a chance for those girls to get a medal, and that's Kiara at the front there right now, leading Andrea Thompson, Tori West, Alicia Burnett, and Sophie Stanwell. Sophie Stanwell is usually the one out there leading the field, usually around 2:18, 2:15. Very, very handy, but these girls are going for PBs, and this is some excellent running here from Kiara.
And hasn't Kiara had a great 2 days? Like, she's competed really well over this two-day competition for the heptathlon, and she looks like she's up for an 800 personal best here. She's running smoothly down the back straight. She's in control. This is where it's going to start to hurt. The bear's going to jump on that back, and she's going to have to really concentrate on holding her form and just concentrate on that breathing, being nice and relaxed, because it's going to hurt.
Yeah, definitely. Now, you can see Andrea Thompson there in second place, a former long jumper, went to World Youth for the long jump in 2015. Sophie Stanwell, fourth place at Glasgow, where she was the only B qualifier we had. And this time we've got an abundance of B qualifiers there. Sophie, we did speak to her earlier today, and she said she was going to try something a little bit different. But it looks like Kiara Dingus really, really wants that PB, and she is striding out now. She's leaving. Andrea Thompson was starting to take a few metres off her, but as we see, maybe she might have gone a little bit too earlier. Andrea really holding on to that technique. It's going to be a fight to this finish line.
Oh, what an effort.
Staying up.
Do you know what? She did everything possible in that 800, and that's what you want to see with these ladies when they're running. Look, you can see her form's all out the door. She's just got lactic flowing through her legs and just makes it to the finish line in an upright position. But what an effort. You see the athletes. You can't see it. Yes, you can just see it on the right of the screen. They're sprawled across the track. It's absolutely destroyed them, those two laps.
I was going to say, very well done there to stay vertical over those last few metres. 8:19 points for both of those. 2:20:31 and 2:20:33 for both Kiara Dingus and Andrea Thompson.
Great effort, Kiara. She put her body on the line. She led that 800 from go to woe. And what a great effort to come away with a good time, like 2:20 for the heptathletes.
She scored herself 5,742 points, which B qualifier.
Yep.
But I think the way that we're looking at these events, I think we're going to end up with all B qualifiers.
Wow.
So we'll wait for this to our score sheet to refresh, and we might be able to see what the total scores are here on our sheets, hopefully very, very soon. But by the looks of it, Celeste Mucci with a 2:26.96.
Oh, look at them. They're in absolute agony out there, the poor things.
Finished with 5,812, so we'll just wait and see what Alicia Burnett. She did finish in front of Alicia Burnett, so I think that would be enough for Celeste Mucci to score herself that nomination.
You know, and you could see before the race, Celeste talking to Alicia. They're out there for the 2 days of comp. They've been competing against each other the whole season. They are good friends, even though they're rivals out there, and they know what they have to do. They respect each other because they know how hard the work is to train for a heptathlon and then to go out there and compete over the two-day carnival. And that's the good thing about heptathlons and decathlons. You can actually see how much they respect each other as competitors.
Yeah, definitely. It's great to see. I love seeing them all get up there on the podium together.
Yeah.
They get everyone out there. It is because they've shared so much together over these few days. As we just try and find our final point scores.